It is game number 81 for the St. Louis Blues and for the Blackhawks. Their final home regular season game will end tomorrow night in Winnipeg, while the Blues will head to Denver for that important game against the Avalanche.
Held in, Murphy or Lisi tried to, it's knocked away. Here comes Brodziak cutting in there, taking a look, trying to throw it across. It didn't work out with Berglund. Rebound, came right through the blue paint. As the Blues almost stuffed it in from behind the goal.
And that was Patrick Berglund, but he just pulled it a little bit wide.
Touched it for Tarasenko. Fights through a check right to the goal, and a save made by Berube. After Tarasenko flew right around Gustafson. Now the Blues get back in. Tarasenko lost it, carried on. Tarasenko, quick shot, rebound. Oh, and a whiff. What a chance for Pietrangelo on the rebound, and he couldn't execute the backhand.
Pietrangelo, the defenseman, is right there. Now he rushes it on the backhand. That puck may be rolling a little bit.
Here's a pass for Kane. He streaks in there. Kane, the shot is blocked, trickling to Hutton, who will cover it up.
This point of the year, you don't want to be, well, watch this.
Turnover to Sharp. His shot smothered. A diving Pietrangelo, I think it hit him right in the breadbasket and stuck to his uniform.
St. Louis Blues defense, and I take that back. That was Brodziak who had come back. And Brodziak, the centerman, trying to go high, hard up the middle, and Patrick Sharp right there.
Hutton mishandled it, left in the corner. What a save he made on DeBrincat, who gets it back. A Carter Hutton turnover led to a great look for Alex DeBrincat. But Hutton able to recover in time to make a terrific point blank save. Here's a takeaway. Yaskin trying to get to the net. He turned it behind, threw it in front. They never got rid of a shot. Sabotka's pass didn't work out with Dunn. Rebound of the Blues, Steen. Now Brodziak. Edmondson's long one tip, they score! The tip slowed the puck down, and a redirect, I believe, by Berglund found the back of the net trickling in, so a late first period goal as the Blues in front.
I think he was looking for this tip the whole way, and there's that job. Well, maybe not. Maybe he's just throwing that towards the front of the net, but a good job by Steen. Alex Steen in the high slot. Maybe it's that Berglund. Yeah, we'll get it right one of these times. That's Berglund, number 21, who only has 14 goals on the season, but he was out a lot.
Only Ruda takes over. His pass picked off. Here's a backhand shot that's thwarted neatly by the good stick work of Hillman. Now taken by Butler. Threw it toward the middle. Backhand shot to Berube on the redirect. Bouncing puck captured by DeBrincat, threw it in front, quick shot, turned by Hutton. Best chance the Hawks have had tonight. Sakura set up by DeBrincat. So two young Blackhawks forwards making something happen right there.
Yeah, the kid line, as you mentioned, Pat, they get a hold of a bouncing puck. Edsel to DeBrincat, he finds Sakura, and that's a good shot. Good anticipation there from Carter Hutton. He slid across from his left to his right.
Backhander picked off. And a chance for Shen. He's got a two-on-one. Shen's going to look for Tarasenko. There's the pass. It was at his feet. And dribbled to Berube.
Tarasenko's a big body, 6 feet, but 225 pounds. He's coming hard to the net. He can't get to the loose puck as Berube uses his mitt just to cover it up.
Kane trying to find a sharp no lane there. Kane takes a look again, snapped it off. Saved by Hutton. Did well to control a rebound and not give up a second chance.
Here's the shot by Kane, but Anisimov and Schmaltz, both right there. Anisimov on the doorstep. Schmaltz will come into the picture. As soon as he saw that shot, he skated towards the net.
It's kept in by Dunn, who goes across. Berglund. And a long wrist shot into the glove of Berube, holding. 4.5 remaining. Steen trying to pry it out of the corner. He did to Berglund. Quick shot. Good save by Berube, and the rebound control of J.F. Berube has been maybe as good tonight as any game he's played as a Blackhawk.
That's why he doesn't like using his blocker. He'd rather have it hit his arm than his blocker or his midsection, and then quick to cover with the glove.
Steal. Kant gets it back, and it throws a quick shot. Good save by Hutton. Flashed out the right pad quickly. Sakura. Fights through a check of Schwartz. He's got it to the forehand. Quick shot. That seemed to be blocked. Then a rebound in behind. Sakura tried to get in front. Didn't happen. Comes this way, Tarasenko. It's Dunn looking for a lane. Tarasenko's one-timer into the glove. A sharp save of J.F. Berube on a sniper.
Yeah, real good stop there. And you've got Braden Schenn trying to take your eyes away, standing in front. Tarasenko can certainly bring it. And there it is, the one-timer. And J.F. Berube just in perfect position. Down in the butterfly, but that glove nice and high.
This is their 81st game. Pareko can't find a lane. Now a long shot tip. Oh, what a save and a redirect. To Berube. A terrific stop on a Sobotka tip.
Yeah, that high slot tip. It's always tough to cover, and it's certainly tough to make the stop on. But watch Berube appearing around traffic and, you know, not overreacting. That's a key to any good goaltender.
Try to make something happen, but Barbashev checked. Dropped back out to the line. Edmondson into the middle, then got it back. Joel Edmondson put it in front. Here's the shot. Backhand shot saved by Berube. Rebound. He made a second stop. Now a big scramble, and the whistle has gone. J.F. Berube looking for Patrick Kane. Where's Sharp? The pass across for Gustafson. Says goal! Erik Gustafson set up by Patrick Kane. Snapped it short side, and this one is tied.
And watch Patrick Kane put the brakes on. He finds the fourth man coming. That's Gustafson. Boy, they've got great chemistry. You see a lot of Kane to Gustafson, Gustafson to Kane. This time Gustafson puts it behind Carter Hutton, ties it at one.
So things going pretty well for 56 Red. Here's a oh, they score on the rebound. A shot hit traffic in front, laid there for Berglund. He's got two goals tonight. The Blues had the game tied, and 16 seconds later, they jump back in front.
Watch him take it deep to the corner, put it back to the point, and then he heads to the net. In a situation, I think that, you know, you look at Osterley, but I think it's Nick Schmaltz. Maybe he has to pick him up. Check your shoulder, see who's open. And it's Berglund who's wide open.
Schenn gets it in. Schenn takes it away, threw it in front of shot. They score. Braden Schenn made all that happen. He picked off a pass, set up Jaden Schwartz. Bang! The Blues now lead by two.
Well, how many times have we seen that? Braden Schenn in behind the goal line, looking for that guy, Jaden Schwartz, number 17. And he does it again. Looked like the Blackhawks were going to get to this puck. And Braden Schenn picks the pocket of Duncan Keith. Kind of lifts his stick, gets to the puck, and boy, what a perfect pass that is.
Board battle won by St. Louis. Berglund rolled into the empty net. It goes in. Patrick Berglund has a hat trick. I'm not sure if he was trying to score there. He just wanted to advance the puck and dribbled off a stick into the net. Patrick Berglund, a three-goal night, and the Blues pick up an important 2 points this evening. And the Blackhawks surrounding one of their leaders, Patrick Sharp, who was a look at this. He's allowed to go to center ice by himself in the final home game of the season. Good move, boys. That's awesome.
This will be his last game at the United.
Look at nobody's going to leave. The teammates won't go in the locker room. They're going to make him take a victory lap. Look at that. That's awesome. If this is indeed the last game he plays in the United Center, Hawks handled it beautifully. Look at the coaching staff. They've stayed on the bench to shake hands and offer their congratulations. So, well done, sharpshooter.
Yeah, what a career.